Retinitis pigmentosa, or RP, is an inherited monogenic disorder where one or more mutations induce progressive retinal degeneration. The condition initially affects the peripheral retina, with abnormal pigment deposits observable outside the macula. However, it eventually begins to progress centrally, causing tunnel vision. This condition is estimated to affect 1.5 million people worldwide, and there is therefore a great unmet need to develop viable treatment options for these patients. Retinitis pigmentosa is genetically heterogeneous, as it can be caused by 67 genes. One enzyme defect in particular is relatively common. Mutations in the phosphodiesterase 6, or PDE6 gene, account for roughly 8% of all autosomal recessive retinitis pigmentosa cases. In order to study this relatively prevalent mutation, a mouse model with a histidine to glutamine substitution in the gene encoding PDE6 was found to phenocopy the human disease. In our paper, we explore a non-gene-specific approach to ameliorating retinal degeneration in the PDE6 mouse model. While we don't fully understand the mechanisms that cause certain mutations to lead to cell death in RP patients, there is a wealth of literature suggesting that metabolic aberrations may underlie or at least contribute to the degeneration. Sirtuin 6, or SIRT6, is a transcriptional repressor of glycolytic enzymes that we consider to be a potential target for altering metabolism in a diseased retina. SIRT6 normally promotes glucose metabolism to proceed through aerobic metabolism, which is a catabolic process where glucose is broken down to produce ATP. We hypothesize that by decreasing SIRT6, glucose would be redirected into anabolic processes, which would help photoreceptors rebuild their outer segments, a process that should occur daily, but does not transpire properly in the background of RP. To test this hypothesis, we introduced an inducible Cre-lock system in the PDE6 model, such that, following tamoxifen injection at postnatal day 7, SIRT6 is knocked out in these mice. We then monitored their disease progression over time.
We found that decreasing SIRT6 in mice preserved photoreceptors' electrophysiological response for longer compared to control mice. Histology sections also demonstrated a more robust outer nuclear layer and intersegment and outer segment layers in terms of their nuclear density and layer thickness, respectively. The outer segments and mitochondria of these mice also appeared healthier on transmission electron microscopy. Rods and cones both appeared to be preserved compared with controls. To tease apart the mechanism underpinning these findings, we assessed how expression of key regulators of glycolytic metabolism changed after 36 ablation. We found that enzymes like HIF1-alpha, GLUT1, GLUT2, and MYC were all upregulated in the knockout mice. We subsequently traced the fate of carbon-13-labeled glucose in these mice. We found that in the 36 knockout mice, glucose more often end up being shuttled into glycolytic pathways, producing intermediates like pyruvate, lactate, and glutamine, as opposed to directly being broken down for ATP. This provides very exciting evidence as a proof of principle, preclinical application of our findings.
Overall, the impact of our data provides evidence that reprogramming metabolism can be an important role in treatment. However, it will be important to assess whether our findings translate to other forms of neurodegenerative diseases. Notably, we also hope to further explore why intervention such as this can slow but not halt disease progression. Future studies will be necessary to develop our findings further, although we are optimistic about the foundation laid by the present data. The strategy for treating retinitis pigmentosa put forth here provides an exceptional example of the interplay between genomics, proteomics, and metabolomics. Genes are like a single color of paint that is applied by the brush of the proteome, which enables a painting to be rendered at the level of the metabolome. Similarly, mutations in genes lead to transcribed proteins like the phosphodiesterase enzyme, that is dysfunctional in our case. This contributes to metabolic defects, which cause diseases. We believe that by developing treatments at the level of the metabolome, we can recreate a beautiful painting regardless of which pains or mutations the patient may have.